Okay, here's a fun question. We are going to find the value of c so that the series when n goes from 2 to infinity with 1 plus c in self parentheses raised to the negative n power, this is going to be equal to 2. So we're not trying to calculate the value of the infinite sum. We know the answer already. We're trying to see how to make things happen. We're trying to figure out the c value so I can plug in and then this will work out nicely, right? Okay, so let's just focus on this to see what kind of series this is. Maybe once we write down a few things right here, we know it much better, right? So this is the series when n goes from 2 to infinity. First of all, I noticed that we have a negative exponent. Of course, just like the good old days, we can put this down into the denominator as 1 over 1 plus c and then raised to the nth power, right? And you notice that, we have n in the exponent. On the top, we have 1. This right here, let me just write it down. This is the sum when n goes from 2 to infinity. 1 is, of course, the same as 1 to the nth power. And in that case, I can look at this as a big parenthesis with 1 over 1 plus c inside like this. And then raised to the nth power, isn't it? Because once of this form, this is the same as 1 to the nth power, which is just 1. And then the denominator to the nth power, which is the original. And now, as we can tell from here, this is almost like a geometric series, right? Because we have a number inside raised to the nth power, isn't it? And suppose this right here, it does converge, and it converges to 2. Well, we have a formula for the infinite geometric sum, right? And the formula says, okay, this is my common ratio, isn't it? And the infinite geometric sum tells us that this is going to be, well, let me just write this down in words for you guys. We have to figure out the first term over 1 minus the common ratio, which is the r that I put down right here. And now, I will have to tell you guys what's the first term. Be careful, this is when n is equal to 2, right? So for the first term, you have to plug in 2 into this n right here. So let me just indicate that for you guys when n is equal to 2 for the first term, right? On the top, we will have 1 over 1 plus c and then raised to the second power, okay? This is the first term. And then we will divide this by 1 minus the common ratio. The common ratio is precisely this, which is 1 over 1 plus c, like that, all right? And now, let's do a few things right here. On the top, it's the same as saying 1 squared, which is 1. On the bottom, right here, it's the same as saying 1 plus c squared, okay? And then right here on the denominator of this part, I will just write it down as how it is, 1 minus 1 over 1 plus c, like that. So this is just pretty much the simplification from here to here, and then this is what we have. Well, this right here is supposed to be the infinite geometric sum, right? And we know that from the question, we want the whole sum to be equal to 2. So I have to set this equal to 2, and then solve this equation. That will be it, right? So as we can see on the right-hand side, I mean the left-hand side, the left-hand side of this equal sign, okay? We have a complex fraction, and let's go ahead and multiply the top and bottom by its lowest common denominator, which is the 1 plus c squared, right? So let's make that happen first. And let's just focus on this part. On the top, this and that will cancel out precisely, so we just have a 1. And on the bottom, I will have to distribute this to that, right? And let me write this down for you guys. 1 plus c square, right? And then when we do this times that, of course, this and that will cancel out, but this was to the second power, so it will be minus, and keep a parenthesis, and we have one more of this factor, 1 plus c like this, okay? And this is equal to 2. Okay, on the bottom, we can do a few steps right here, right? This right here, it's the same as saying 1 plus 2c plus c squared after you multiply this out. And for this, you can just distribute as usual, minus 1 minus c. So all in all, this is 1 over let's put down the c squared first. And 2c minus c, that's just plus c. And then the 1 minus 1 just cancel each other out. So this is what we have, 1 over c squared plus c. And we're going to make this equal to 2. And now let's, of course, we can multiply both sides by c squared plus c like this, okay? C squared plus c, right? So that this and that will cancel. And we have 1 equals 2. This is 2c squared plus 2c after you distribute. Quadratic equation, minus 1 on both sides. So in other words, we have 2c squared. Let me just put this down right here nicely for you guys. Plus 2c minus 1 equals to 0. Is this factorable? I don't think so. So quadratic formula, right? OK, this is going to be c equals to, well, a is 2, b is 2, c is equal to negative 1, just like the good old days. C is equal to negative b, which is 2 right here, and then plus minus square root of b squared, which is 2 squared right here, and then minus 4 times a times c. A is 2, c is negative 1, so let's put this down. All over 2 times a, which is 2, like that, right? Okay, this is negative 2 plus minus. Open the square root, and let's do this in your head. 2 squared is 4, and then this is 4 times 2, which is 8, times 1, still 8. This is 4 plus 8, which is a total of 12, right? And then this is all over 2 times 2, which is 4, and now let's keep going. And you can factor this out, you know, break this apart as square root of 4 times square root of 3, isn't it? So you can see this is negative 2 plus minus this square root of 4, which is the same as 2. And then you have the square root of 3 all over 4, like this. And if you would like, you can factor out the 2 on the top, which is 2 and then negative 1 plus minus square root of 3, so that this and that can be reduced, right? Okay, at the end, we have negative 1 plus minus square root of 3 all over 2 on the bottom. And now we notice that we have two possibilities for c, right? The first one is negative 1 plus square root of 3 all over 2. And the other one is negative 1 minus square root of 3 all over 2. Shall we take both of them? Well, maybe there's only one answer. Well, maybe both of them don't work. Well, let me tell you guys first now. C is equal to negative 1 plus square root of 3 all over 2. This right here is the only answer. Okay? And now, please pause the video and think about it. How come this is the only answer? How come negative 1 minus square root of 3 all over 2? It's not going to work for the original series. And please don't tell me because that was a minus, because that's a negative. Okay, it's not just like that. Anyway, I'm going to erase the board now. And now let me tell you guys why this is the only c value that will make that work. If you look back to this again, you see, this is r to the nth power. And the way that we did this was, we look at this as an infinite geometric sum, right? And in order for this to converge, remember, we have to make sure that the absolute value of r has to be less than 1. So right here, let me just write it down. We must make sure the absolute value of r is less than 1 in order for us to get the convergent series. Well, we have to double check now when we plug in the c into this. You see, r is equal to 1 over 1 plus c. We have to make sure that the result has to be less than 1, its absolute value wise. So we have to check both c values, OK? And let me just show you guys the right one first. This is negative 1 for the c plus square root of 3 all over 2, right? OK, I'll plug in this into this c right here. And that will give us the r, which is 1 over 1 plus c is this, negative 1 plus square root of 3 all over 2, right? And this is just a complex fraction. We can multiply the top and bottom by this 2. So we can simplify that. And you will notice that on the top is 2, on the bottom, 2 times 1, right? So you have 2. And this times 1 cancel out. So you have minus 1 and then plus square root of 3. Right? this and that cancel, so you have minus 1 plus root 3, and 2 times 1 is 2. And now this is 2 over 2 minus 1 is just 1, and then this is plus square root of 3. Square root of 3 is about 1.7 something plus 1. It's going to be bigger than that, right? Bigger than 2. So this right here is less than 1. So it checks. This R value works. So this C value is an answer. And now the other one, let me just put this down real quick. We'll check if C is equal to negative 1 minus square root of 3 all over 2, right? Do the same thing. R is going to be 1 over 1 plus this C value now, negative 1 minus square root of 3 all over 2. And then we can just multiply the top and bottom by 2 again. On the top, we still get 2. On the bottom, 2 times 1 is 2. And then 2 and 2 cancel, and we will have minus 1 minus square root of 3, isn't it? And in this case, though, we'll end up with what? On the top, this is 2 over, on the bottom, 2 minus 1 is still 1, but then if you minus square root of 3 in this case. Well, let's look at the absolute value of r, right? So let's just apply the absolute value, because I have to look at the absolute value of r. Earlier, this r was positive, so the absolute value didn't matter. But I should still put it down if you guys would prefer me to do so, right? But anyway, let's look at this right here. On the top, we have 2. On the bottom, as I said, this is 1 minus square root of 3, it's about 1.7 something. Here we have 2 over 0.7 something. And when you divide 2 with 0.7 something, you get something that's bigger than 2 for sure. Bigger than 1, actually, sorry. This is going to be bigger than 1 for sure, isn't it? So this r value with the absolute value of r is bigger than 1. It wouldn't work. That's why we had to reject negative 1 minus square root of 3 all over 2. Right? So this is not the correct C value. This is the only answer. And that's why I told you guys this right here earlier. Anyway, that's it.